The sacrament of baptism is the first one that we receive. When we talk about sacraments as being outward signs, the signs used in each sacrament point to the spiritual and eternal meaning which they signify. So, for example, the primary symbol in baptism is water. And water represents three things. First, water is pure. It's what we use to clean things. And so it's a physical way of seeing what's happening spiritually, even though the body is cleansed by water, so our spirit and hearts are cleansed of original sin. Water is also a symbol of life. Nothing can live without water. So water represents the share in the resurrection and new life of Christ that we receive when we pass through the waters of baptism to new life and regeneration. But water is also a symbol of death, drowning. In the ancient world, John the Baptist would plunge people under the water, symbolizing their death. In ancient churches, baptistries looked like coffins or holes in the ground where people would go in to be buried and emerge, resurrected to new life. We don't do many immersion baptisms in the church in the Western world, but it's the reason why we pour water over the heads of children in baptism, not their hands or their feet, because it represents immersion, being sharers in the death of Christ so that we can also share in his resurrection. There's also two anointings in baptism. The first anointing is a blessing of protection that goes near the chest to symbolize a shield. Oil was used for protection in the ancient world so that soldiers were more difficult to grab or to strike. So that oil represents a shield of the Holy Spirit that temptations and anxieties can slide off when we're faced with them in the world. Then the second anointing is after the baptism, we're given a blessing of chrism on the crown of our heads, representing the fact that we are now members of God's holy and, yes, royal family. And so we should see in ourselves a share in the family of God, and we should see Jesus Christ in each other, crowned with chrism and blessed by the waters of baptism. Once we receive the water and are anointed, we have received the fullness of that sacrament, but then we have to cooperate with those graces so that we truly have put ourselves to death and can live in the new life of the risen Christ.